T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1, 0, and liftoff of Space Shuttle Atlantis on a mission to build, resupply, and to do research on the International Space Station.
Houston now controlling.
Not a Mercury vehicle, but imagine the worst possible situation for the astronaut, that his capsule is now mounted on top of this Atlas. The escape rocket takes the capsule away from the booster.
Seconds into the launch, the onboard computers decided 501 was 90 degrees off course.
Stable in pitch, yaw, and roll. Then a failure occurred involving one engine. And shortly thereafter, another engine also lost power. It was therefore necessary for the range safety officer to destroy the missile by remote control. From the missile fell on the test base and in the sea just offshore from the base. Nearly all critical components were recovered. These parts and data radioed to the ground during flight were studied to isolate the exact cause of the trouble.
A very well-known picture for those collector of rocket pictures. This was really spectacular almost from the get-go. We see the vehicle lifting off and essentially coming over immediately and being destroyed by range safety, at least to the extent it can be destroyed by range safety at that altitude. There's a view from the other side. The Juno 2 was a vehicle put together by the Von Braun Group at what became the Marshall Space Flight Center in response to a requirement to have a vehicle with some marginal amount of lunar payload throw weight.
Ignition sequence start and lift liftoff of the SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket, adding to the International Space Station access for future American rockets. And Falcon has cleared the tower.
Stage 1 propulsion is nominal. Vehicle's programming downrange. Stage 1 propellant utilization is active.
Power to mothership nominal. Power to mothership remain nominal.
Impact chill has begun. T plus 2 minutes. Altitude 32 kilometers. Speed 1 kilometer per second. Downrange distance 13 kilometers.
Data coming back shows vehicle on course, on track.
Scheduled to study the performance of the temperamental hydrogen fuel. The Centaur is designed to put a payload of more than a ton on the moon or 1,000 pounds in the vicinity of Mars or Venus. The first few seconds of the shoot go without incident. The Centaur climbs to 30,000 feet, then malfunction. The immediate cause of the explosion is not known, but if it happened in the Atlas booster, it means a probable delay for the next U.S. orbital flight by astronaut Malcolm Carpenter. Long-lens cameras capture pieces of the wrecked missile falling into the sea, falling like a wounded bird. However, in the race for space, scientists find progress in every failure.